So solar radiation, storage boiler, three-way valve, damper, rock bed storage, AXA heater, AXA bypass, exhaust air, hot air to distribution, and used hot air from the distribution and the fresh air. So it is given as a term called heat exchanger. So now we had a complete connections from how to where to where we have to be done, and finally we are getting a hot air distribution. So first one, the thermal energy transport from collector to through the hot air, and it relates for the heat process. Means whatever you are getting at the end, this is a hot air distribution portion. So from this you are using for the process of heat. Then the excess heat is stored in rock bed thermal storage. So you can see the rectangular box available here. This is a rock bed. Means if you are getting excess heat more than the required, that excess heat we are moving it and storing in some place. And you know that our best advantage of rock bed is during night time we can utilize this heat for processing. So that is the best advantage of rock bed storage. So people are having the excess heat will be stored in rock bed thermal storage to use later when the solar radiations is not available. Then auxiliary heating augment the supply when the heat is supplied by the collector or storage is not sufficient. So it's like your auxiliary parts, or you can call extra parts which is available. Backups, you can call it as a backups. So auxiliary heating segment will be available when your storage is not sufficient. Then the used air is passed through heat exchanger to recover the heat from the exhaust air to rise at the initial temperature of fresh air entering the collector. Means it is like recycling. You are not wasting anything. You are taking the air, whatever the residual left out, again we are using it for a further usage in the complete process. So that's what they say, the used air is passed through heat exchanger. You can see the direction, fresh air, used hot air for the distribution. So if anything is left out, so you are taking it as a feedback. So heat exchanger to recover the heat from the exhaust air to rise the initial temperature. Again from this, like from the waste, again you are doing the same process of getting the heat, and that will be entering to the collector portion. Next we have pressurized water is circulated through a concentrating collector to prevent boiling. Say I think I moved to the another one, just a minute. This is the major process of your hot air industrial process heat system. So next, addition to this, this is hot air industrial process heat system. So next we have one more term called solar process steam system, because you have hot air, water and steam. So I'll just enlarge the picture. Solar process for steam system, where you have a concentrating collector field. So field like design can be different, and there are multiple they are used. Then pressurized hot water, one tube that has been shown is for the bi-directional, it is given. One is collector pump, another one is a feed water control valve. Means it is input and this is the output you are taking it off, and that will be given to the concentrating solar panels. Then pressurized hot water, from here it will going to produce water. Pressurized you are getting, it means you are getting in terms of steam, and that will be taken up, and you have a valve. Means based on the requirement you can take off the pressure output. Means you can make it as 10%, 20%, 30%. Whatever you want can be done through this valve. Finally, you are going to get process steam. So it is like a tap. Whatever the control you are making at 0%, 10%, same as say pressure receiving valve, restricting or regulating valve, we can say that. Next to feed water, means from, it is like tank, and then you have a valve. From there valve, we are going to the tube, and from the tube again you're taking back to the collector pump, and it will say rise the temperature of the water. If you're heating to the highest temperature, then only water will convert into a steam. So here the major part is pressurized hot water. So earlier in the heat exchanger, here pressurized hot water. So we'll see in step by step. First, pressurized water is circulated through a concentrating collector to prevent boiling. The high pressure heated water is throttled and flush separated in a flush separator. So here you have, sorry, not a flush, a separator. So this heat exchanger and as well as a flush separator. This is the place it will going to segregate the variation of temperature in the water, low and high. Okay, to maintain the necessary liquid level in the flush tank, boiled feed water is injected into the pump section. Means see, if you are boiling, it will definitely, it will reduce the quantity of water. If your tank is filled normal water, same quantity will be there, volume will be same. If you start boiling and if you forgot to switch off, so what will happen? The quantity will started reducing because most of the water is evaporated. So that's what say the to maintain the necessary liquid level, you will have a minimum point. Okay, this must be the minimum level. Maximum you can have, but minimum. So for that reason, what they are doing? Boiled feed water is injected to the pump section. So this is the collector pump section. You are going to feed it. Then the saturated steam obtained from the flash separator is recirculated through the collector feed and distributed for the use. So here also, like you are not wasting a single point also. So first, if you are going to check out the level, if the level is not like maintaining, then you have to pump it. So if you get saturated level, saturated output more than the required, then again you are taking that from the flush separator. So flush separator will go to distribute at the saturated steam level. And again, it is recirculated to the collector field. And from there, again, you are going for distribution, like continuous process. You are feeding a water valve, then giving to the flush separator. It will go to check out the saturation level as well as the pressurized condition, how much hot water should not boil. So if it boil, again, it will reduce the value. Then you are giving to the collector pump, recirculating the system and going with the process. Okay, a pressure regulator valve regulates the pressure system. How much must be? So pressure you have to control. How much pressure you have to maintain for particular process should be known before doing it. Okay.